With the optional file transmitter FTXH grip, we'll be able to send photos and videos easily to an FTP server.
It is also possible to shoot tethered to a local area network, either wired or wirelessly.
In addition, there's the ability to control up to 4 compatible cameras from a browser via the remote rec function. Hi, my name is Billy.
And I'm Francis.
And we're the Fuji guys.
In this video, we will show you how to set up the FTP function.
Let's begin by removing the connector cover on the file transmitter grip and storing it in a safe place. Remove the connector cover located on the bottom of the camera and keep it aside for now. Remove the battery tray from the file transmitter grip. You'll notice a slot in the tray where you can store the camera's connector cover. Place at least one NPW235 battery in the tray before inserting it back into the grip and securing it in place. Align the file transmitter grip to the underside of the camera body, ensuring that the connectors on the grip matches up with the ones on the body, and slowly turn the dial on the grip to lock it in place.
Access to the network and USB features is only available when a battery is inserted in the camera and at least one battery is inserted into the file transmitter grip.
Before we begin, the following information is required to complete the setup. We will need the FTP server type, server address, the port number, and username and password. If a proxy server is required, this information will also be needed to complete the setup. Once we have obtained all the necessary FTP information, we can begin setup. On the camera, press the menu OK button to bring up the menu screen. Navigate to the network USB settings menu and select Create Edit Connection Settings. Select Create Using Wizard, FTP Transfer, Create New, and then press the menu OK to proceed with the COMM settings. We can select the type of connections we want to use.
Wireless LAN will allow you to connect to a local Wi-Fi connection. Wired LAN uses an Ethernet cable to connect to the local network. This allows for a fast and stable connection to the FTP server. USB smartphone will make use of the cellular network of your smartphone to transfer images to the FTP server.
For this example, we'll select the wireless LAN option. Select Create New from the list. Now we need to configure the access point settings.
If your access point has a WPS button on it, you can select a simple setup to connect to the Wi-Fi router instead.
Select Manual Setup, select from network list, and choose a network from the list that appears. Next, select IP address settings and choose auto if you want the IP address to be automatically assigned. We now need to input the name for the COMM settings.
The COMM setting we just created can be reused when creating new connection settings. Using a simple and clear name like wireless or wired makes it easy to find the right communication setting for the future.
Once completed, we'll now set up the FTP server setting. Select Create New and choose the FTP server type that you will connect to.
FTPS and SFTP are secured file transfer protocols. Selecting FTPS for FTP server type lets you choose the authentication method. If desired, you can load a self-signed root certificate using FTP optional setting and then going to root certificate.
Using the FTP information we gathered earlier, we'll now enter them here. Unless a proxy server is required, please select Disable. Select Enable for passive mode and enter the username and password for the FTP server.
For connection to servers that do not require username and password, select Anonymous.
Most FTP servers use a passive connection. Unless your FTP server uses an active connection, passive mode should be enabled.
Once all information has been entered, you need to specify the target folder.
This is case sensitive, so make sure that the folder name matches with the folder on the FTP server.
To prevent files from being overwritten, select No. Now enter a name for the FTP server.
The FTP server setting we just created can be reused when creating new connection settings. Using a simple and clear name makes it easy to find the right FTP server setting for the future.
Finally, we can enter the name for the connection settings that we just created. If you'd like to test this connection, select OK. The setup is now complete. Choose Select if you wish to connect to the FTP server.
The status of the connection to the network or FTP server is shown by an icon on the electronic viewfinder or LCD monitor. You can also see a status light on the file transmitter grip.
Now that everything is properly configured, we can begin using this new feature. In the FTP optional settings, we can set the images to be automatically transferred to the FTP server when an image is taken or manually select them.
For additional information about the FTP optional settings, please watch our other video on this topic.
We hope you enjoy this tutorial.
Thank you for watching.